your makeup just so. Guess you don't know that you're beautiful. Try on every dress that you own. You were fine in my eyes a half hour ago. And if your mirror won't make it any clearer, I'll be the one to let you staring. Tell all of these boys they're wasting their time. Stop standing in line, 'cause you're all mine. And this evening I won't let the feeling die. I never wanna leave your side. Out of all of the girls, you're my one.
Of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, welcome on behalf of Duran and Tahirah to this beautiful day to celebrate the gift of love and marriage. Grace and peace be yours in abundance through the knowledge of God and our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. The congregation may be seated. Friends, hear the word of the Lord. God is love, and those who abide in love abide in God, and God abides in them. On behalf of Duran and Tahirah, I'd like to thank you for carving out time in your Fall Friday morning to show your support and love to this couple as they begin their life together. And now a very important question. who gives this woman to this man? All righty. Duran, please go get your bride. We made it. Friends, we have come together in the presence of God for the marriage of Duran and Tahirah, to share their joy and to promise them our love and support. Christian marriage is a joyful covenanting. In this covenant, they proclaim before God and human witnesses their commitment to live together in spiritual, physical, and material unity. In this covenant, they acknowledge that the great love God has shown for them enables them to love each other. They affirm that God's gracious presence and abiding power are needed for them to keep their vows, to continue to live in love and to be faithful servants of Christ in this world. Human commitment is fragile and human love is imperfect, but the promise of God is eternal, and the love of God can bring our love to perfection. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Maker and Redeemer, as you gladdened the wedding at Cana by the presence of your Son, so by your Spirit bring joy to this day. Let the love we celebrate today be a sign of your eternal love. As we honor the union of Duran and Tahirah, draw us into deeper unity with you, through Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. At this time, I invite Cheryl to come forward for our first reading. Amen. Thank you, Cheryl. As Cheryl makes her way back, we now come to the service known as the Declarations of Intent. I'd like to ask you, Duran, and you, Tahirah, two important questions, and then I'm going to ask your family and friends gathered a very important question as well. Duran, do you take Tahirah to be your wife?
I do.
Will you love her, comfort her, honor and protect her.
I will.
And forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live.
I will.
And Tahirah, do you take Duran to be your husband?
I do.
Will you love him, comfort him, honor and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Why don't you turn around real quick? Because this is some of the most important part in the wedding ceremony is the affirmations of family and friends. You see, Duran and Tahirah, you would not be here if it would not be for all of the love and support of your family and friends gathered together. And as you look out and see their faces, just consider with me, take a trip down memory lane of all of the birthdays celebrated and anniversaries commemorated, Christmas mornings, and all of the wonderful times that you've had with these family and friends. And family and friends, as you reflect on this couple and the love and the grace that has brought them together as individuals and now as a union, do you promise to pray and encourage and support and be there for this couple in the future as you have done so in the past? If your response is in the affirmative, give me a boisterous "we will."
We will.
Amen. A reading from Paul's epistle to the church in Ephesus, Ephesians chapter 5, verses 21 through 33. Hear the word of the Lord. Be subject to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives, be subject to your husbands as you are to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, just as Christ is the head of the church, the body of which he is the Savior. Just as the church is subject to Christ, so wives also ought to be in everything to their husbands. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her in order to make her holy by cleansing her with the washing of water by the word, so as to present the church to himself in splendor, without spot or wrinkle or anything of any kind. Yes, so that she may be holy and without blemish. In the same way, husbands should love their wives as they do their own bodies, for he who loves his wife loves himself. For no one ever hates his own body, but he nourishes and tenderly cares for it, just as Christ does for the church, because we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a great mystery, and I am applying it to Christ and the church. Each of you, however, should love his wife as himself, and a wife love her husband. Friends, this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Amen.
I just want to share with you a few words. That first verse, Ephesians chapter 5, verse 21, says, be subject to one another out of reverence for Christ. The theme is being a servant. Serve one another as Christ serves us. And throughout the Bible, Jesus gives a beautiful portrait of what service looked like. Jesus washed his disciples' feet. Jesus cared for the poor and the lame and the sick. Jesus gave food to those who were hungry. Jesus opened the eyes of those who were blind. Jesus was a perfect example of a servant. But did you know what another word in the Bible for servant is? The word in Greek, the New Testament's heart language, what it can also be translated to? Did you know this? Waiter. Waiter.
Waiter.
It's true. A waiter. It's the same word for waiter. And here we have this couple. You know about being a waiter and a waitress and anything else that has to do with the restaurant business. Friends, did you know that this couple hosted a party at their restaurant, The Jungle, last night? Not for themselves, for someone else. This is the kind of servants that Duran and Tahirah are. And I want to encourage you, throughout your married life together, don't lose that. Don't lose that posture of being a waiter. I know that you're tired, man. You got a lot on your plate, buddy. And you have so much going on as you merge families and welcome a new one into the world soon and grow this beautiful family. But don't forget to be waiters and waitresses to each other out of reverence and love for Christ. Because Christ gives us this perfect example of service. And I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but life is hard. And there's never a downtime. It's always busy and full. So I would encourage you to take time. Take time for each other. Take time for yourselves so that you can be renewed and fresh to be those waiters and waitresses to each other. So after a long day of being at the restaurant or all the many other things, the other plates that you have spinning, keep on being a waiter and a waitress, but in a different kind. Maybe not always giving, you know, each other food, but serving one another. Find ways every day to serve one another. Find one way to put the wants and the thoughts and the needs of the other ahead of yourself. And look to Jesus, the pioneer and the perfecter of our faith. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Pray with me, please. God, we thank you for your word that is alive and active in our hearts today. We are so grateful for the posture of service that you portray in the life of Jesus. And God, may we, by the power and presence of your Holy Spirit, embody that posture of service to be a waiter and a waitress to those in our lives, and especially to husbands and wives. We ask all this in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Well, now we come to reciting our vows. And I have a quick question for you, Duran, before we make our promises. When you were kind of, you know, constantly checking out, visiting Tahirah at the Brooks Brothers store, always looking for new duds, even though she didn't first give you the time of day, did you think that you'd be here?
Yes.
You did.
Yes.
You did. That's God's providence. Amen. Did you think so, Tahirah?
Yes.
You did. You can look back on that.
Yep.
I love it. I love it. Duran and Tahirah join hands and in faith make their promises to each other. Duran, repeat after me. I, Duran, take you, Tahirah, to be my wife.
I, Duran, take you, Tahirah, to be my wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and behold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we should both shall live.
To this covenant I pledge myself.
To this covenant I pledge myself.
Truly with all my heart.
Truly with all my heart.
Amen.
Amen.
And Tahirah, repeat after me. I, Tahirah, take you, Duran, to be my husband.
I, Tahirah, take you, Duran, to be my husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
To this covenant I pledge myself.
To this covenant I pledge myself.
Truly with all my heart.
Truly with all my heart.
Duran and Tahirah have chosen rings as an unending sign for their unending love for each other. I invite our ring bearer to come forward. Do we have the rings? Come on up, Mason. Come on, buddy. You have something very special in that box. Oh, thank you. Great job, buddy. Okay.
Thank you.
You want to take the rings and then give Lockley the box?
That is so wrong.
Okay. I'll take the box.
You take that. I'll take it out. And take my ring out.
He's got the rings.
This is for me.
This is for me. Loxley, we're going to give you these. Okay.
Oh, that thing.
Okay. Beautiful.
You first?
Duran, repeat after me. Tahirah, I give you this ring.
Tahirah, I give you this ring.
As a sign of the covenant we have made today.
As a sign of the covenant we have made today.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
And Tahirah, repeat after me. Duran, I give you this ring.
Duran, I give you this ring.
As a sign of the covenant we have made today.
As a sign of the covenant we have made today.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation and giver of all grace, look with favor upon the world you have made and redeemed, and especially upon Tahirah and Duran. Give them wisdom and devotion in their life together, that each may be to the other a companion in joy, a comfort in sorrow, and a strength in need. Give them the grace, when they hurt one another, to recognize and confess their faults and seek each other's forgiveness and yours. Make their life together be a sign of Christ's love to this lost and fallen world, that unity may overcome estrangement, that forgiveness would heal guilt, and joy would conquer despair. Enrich with your grace this family, that loving and supporting one another, they may serve those in need and be a sign of your kingdom. Grant your Spirit to unite all your children, so that your peace and justice may fill the earth through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Duran and Tahirah have made their covenant of marriage together before God and all here present by solemn vows with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings. Therefore, I declare that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Duran, you may kiss your beautiful bride. And now, dear friends, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be and abide with us on this beautiful and holy day and every day. Amen. And it is my great privilege to introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Duran and Tahirah Foxton.
Thank you.
tonight. Ain't nobody in the world but you and I.
So we're going to start bringing in the bridal party. The first group we have coming in is mother of the groom.
Bring the beat in.
Stepmom. Althea and Marcia, escorted by Ashton. Give them a round of applause. Yes. Welcome. Work it. The show. We have coming in Siobhan and Latiana.
Yeah. 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 Ye
Yeah. Real thing, baby. And so real. the newlywed Foxtons, Duran and Tahirah. Can we give a round of applause for the newlyweds? Round of applause. Okay, so at this moment, I'm going to open the microphone to some toasts to the newlyweds, starting with the best man and father of the groom, Ricky. It's your time to shine. Father of the groom and best man, Ricky.
Good afternoon, everyone. Listen, I've never seen so many beautiful people in one place. Big up on yourself. I'm really honored to be here. Are you? Yeah. Okay. this is a special day. Okay, Duran. It's my firstborn son. There's so much I could say. Okay, there's so much I could say, Duran. You are more than just a son. You know, you are my best friend. You know, we always have this special bond together. We are so close. You know, you are my best friend. You have come a far way. And I'm honored to be your father. And now, your best man. We are coming from so far away, from the garrison in Jonestown. A lot of people call it jungle. That's where we all from. You have lived through seeing deaths and destruction in the street. There are times when guys walking down the road with one gun on one hip and a bazooka on the other hip. And if I fly past them, I dead him dead. That's the place where we are from. You have lived through seeing all these things, and look at you now. I realize that you love to cook at the age of 8. You prepare food with such a passion. Yeah, you put everything in it, no matter where you are. That's you. And that's in the gene. Because the Foxton family, we all can cook. So that's where it's coming from. Know your passion, it's your career. I'm so glad that you see that you have decided to enter into a new chapter in your life. The same passion you show in cooking career, you can apply it at a greater level as a husband. I've been a husband for 22 years, and every day I made choice to love my wife and be the greatest husband I can be. My advice to you as your best man is to keep the passion and know that you're a husband. Your passion will keep your marriage alive. Choose your passion daily The Bible says that husbands are to love their wives the way that Christ loved the church. The Bible also says, he who find a wife find a good thing. I love you and I'm so proud of you. Yeah. Lastly, but not least, welcome to the family, Tierra Faxton. I'm so proud of you to be in the family. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Mr. and Mrs. Faxton.
Beautiful words by Ricky, best man and father of the groom. Thank you, Ricky. Can we have a round of applause for Ricky, everyone? Ricky is partially the reason why Duran is here. And without Ricky, Duran wouldn't be here. And without Duran being here, we wouldn't have this wedding. Next up, we have the maid of honor, Kamisha. Round of applause for Kamisha. Let's give her some encouragement. Yes, Kimmy, yes.
Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Faxton. Tahirah, it was an honor to stand by you today. When I think back of our history over the years, creating mischief together in school, our corny nicknames, forever joking and can't take anything serious, shopping experiences where you always get into with everybody, us doing each other's hair and swear we was killing it. But most importantly, being there for each other through memorable milestones. So truthfully, there are no words that can sum up my appreciation for you as a friend and the fact that you chose me to be a part of this special day. Just know I would have done this for you in any lifetime, even working off of 1 hour of sleep. To the both of you, I'm glad you made the decision to flourish your love story that day in Brooks Brothers. So I can stand here today and tell you both that you are one of the strongest couples I know. You've created a beautiful family. You've conquered so much together. Your union is backed by God, faith, and you created love in all of this. So Duran, I thank you for making one of my best friends, my sister, a wife. Tahirah, you are truly happy, and that is all that matters. In my eyes, you guys are winners. Congratulations again.
Beautiful words by Kamisha. Thank you, thank you. Round of applause for Kamisha. Maid of honor. And now, we're gonna have a few special toasts. The ones were special, but these will be even more special. I'm gonna invite Latiana, daughter of the groom, to come up and give a toast. Round of applause for Latiana, ladies and gentlemen.
So, hi, my name is Latiana. I'm the daughter of the groom. My father is the best dad in the entire world. He's very caring, loving, and he always looks out for me, for my best interests. And now that he met his perfect match, thank you to Tahirah for being there for my dad. And thank you for being the maternal figure here for me while my mom is in Jamaica. I wish you guys nothing but happiness. I love you guys so much.
Yeah, hello everyone. So first and foremost, I want to congratulate my mom and Duran for entering their new chapter. I appreciate everything you guys have done for me, and I'm very proud of you two. And wish you guys nothing but the best. I love you both.
Hi, Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for coming to celebrate this beautiful affair for Tahirah and Duran. My princess, always a beautiful girl, beautiful in spirit, beautiful in ways. I mean, think she did so cute when she born. She was always cute. I love you. You're a princess, and now you're a queen. Queen, me bless you. Me love you. Much love. God blessing. And King, I'm happy for both of you. I admire you. I watch you. I see how nurturing you are, how loving you are to your family. And I see you do the same thing for my daughter. And I pray and wish you continued blessing, continued love, peace, everything that is great. All right, amen.
I got nervous. Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone. My name is Loxley Foxton Jr., the brother of Duran Foxton. I've known Duran for a very, very long time. How long? We used to sleep on the same bed with four other girls. That's how long I've known this man. This man has taught me a whole lot over the years. When I was hungry, he taught me how to gamble to make money to feed myself. And he was very good at it, and I became very good at it. But unfortunately, we had to quit. When I left Florida to came to New York, I had no one but Duran. Duran took me in. He clothed me, he sheltered me, and he did everything possible to make me happy. And today, I am very successful in what I do because of Duran Foxton. And I'm extremely happy to be your brother, and I wouldn't want it any other way. And Tahirah, I want you to know that everything he has done it for you, and I'm very happy for both of you guys. Congratulations.
So eager is the father of the bride to give his speech. He didn't even let me do his special introduction. Ladies and gentlemen, father of the bride.
Hello, everyone. How y'all doing? I just want to say congratulations to Duran and my daughter. From Tahirah was like 4 or 5. I seen in her that she is a leader still, you know? Because like when Christmas used to come around, she used to get a little pocket money and stuff. And when Christmas came around, everybody would get a little something from her. So I seen it in her from jump that she was going to be like successful, you know? And I'm proud of you, baby. And I just want Duran to know, take care of my baby, you know what I say? And if you have any problem, there's a whole bunch of people you can talk to and call and try work it out. There's going to be problems all along. But I want to remember Tahirah that like the way the restaurant started, when every business have a struggle, just like a marriage. You understand? And just the way you got successful right now, I want you to push on. And if you have a problem, work it out and push on just like that. And you'll be good. Love you, baby. The best. See? Yeah.
Hello, hello, hello. Is this working? I don't need no introduction. Everybody know who I am. If you don't, I don't need no introduction. If you don't know who I am, you will get to know who I am. I'd like to say congrats to Duran, Tahirah. You got yourself a Jaffe, you know, or AKA Steppers. It's an inside joke. You know, normally Tahirah, she is always behind me, following behind me, and so, but now she's ahead of me. And I'm proud of you, you know, always there for you. I'm gonna be there forever. Now that you and Duran is together, I'll be there for the both of y'all, you know? And again, congrats to y'all. You know, I normally don't do this, and y'all should be special. All right.
Devin, brother of the bride, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello, everyone. I'm Yashmin, I'm Duran's sister. And I'm the other sister, my brother, we're talking about, I sleep on the bed. So now you know that we come a long way. That's my oldest brother out of 12, I think. I can't, at least, I can't count no more. But Duran, I love you. Tahirah, I love you. God has gave me a beautiful sister. And I wrote you a note before, but I want to say it again because it means a lot to me. God is smiling in heaven because this is his will for two to become one in spirit and in truth in him. Marriage is your first ministry. So honor, respect, and be accountable for each other. Put God first because he is the first chord in the 3-4 chord. This marriage will not be broken. I'm going to say it again. This marriage will not be broken. I want everybody to say it with me. This marriage will not be broken. I'm going to say it one more time because the devil mad. This marriage will not be broken. As long as God is first, because he is the glue that conceals y'all together. Your marriage is a reflection of Christ. I love you guys. Keep him first and love her. If you respect her, you respect God. When you lose respect of her, you leave respect in God. Love him like your own body. Love her like your own body. Thank you, guys. I love you guys.
Tahirah Duran. We're Tahirah's cousins. On behalf of everybody who couldn't be here today, we just want to say congratulations to both of you. We love you. Tahirah, you know how I feel about you. Duran, when I met you, you know, in Jamaica, they say, my spirit take you. From then, right? So welcome to the family. We're big grand family, but we love you. We will always be here for you. May God bless your marriage.
Yeah. All right, I'll just echo the sentiment. I'm Krista, I'm one of her cousins. I don't know if anyone knows this, but there's 170 something. Your baby's probably 173. First and second grand cousins in our family tree. So you got a big family. We're here to support you and welcome to the family, Duran. Congrats.
What's up, everybody? I'm JD, Tahirah's cousin. I've seen Tahirah and Durant when they first got together. I've seen them through now. I'm super proud of you guys, both of you guys. And just Tahirah's like, may not know, but like you're very special to me. And there's times when I'm like feeling down and Tahirah would just hit me out of the blue. Tuesday night, 5:25 p.m. with a Bible scripture. And just always checks on me. And when I call her to check on her, she's always accomplishing something. We just opened a restaurant, just got a house. I think I'm gonna do a jungle juice bar down the block. Like, she's just, yo, like, I went to the Benz dealer. Like, what do you think about, like, we're always, like, patting each other on and being like, you're super successful. I think Durant, you got a winner, bro. Like, she's, so I'm really happy for you guys. You guys look amazing. Like, I think I wanted to get that suit, Durant, when you French, when you wear that. But proud of you guys, love you guys. I'm super happy to be here. That's it.
Tahirah Scarlett Grant. That's how we call, that's how we relate to each other. Because the first time I met her, I said, what's your name? She said, Tahirah Scarlett Grant. And so that's our motto throughout. But one of the striking things about Tahirah and our bond was the first time she stayed with me, she left something. And I thought it was weird because I packed her bag and she said, I left it so I could come back. And we've bonded ever since. I still have that jacket, Tahirah. Tahirah is special. I mean, I have a lot of nieces and everyone is special. And so I treat each one accordingly. But Tahirah is goal-oriented and that's striking about her. She always have a plan. She always have a plan. She's always doing something. And one another admirable thing about her is that she listens and she confides and she asks for direction. Happy for you guys, Durant. You know we kick it from day one. Love you guys. Congratulations so much. I love you guys with all my heart. Big up to my brother, because without him, there would be no Tahirah. And the Grants and Rose and all the family welcomes you, Durant. God bless you.
Look what you mean to me, hey, look what you mean to me. It really nice enough to live our lives in love, huh? And I need you clean, you said you would be my queen. You saved me life enough, superhero love. Born to spend my life together, save the day, my Wonder Woman. Love the way you ride it right on, clear the world with all that you want. The feeling you can't measure where you better come in life, me I get a feel. Don't listen rumor, them who have mess up with love. Matter how a girl pretty, hey, let go me know. Look what you mean to me, hey, look what you mean to me. It really nice enough to live our lives in love, huh? And I need you clean, you said you would be my queen. You saved me life enough, superhero love. Everybody want to me love you so them nah know. Solid as a rock, a metaphoric ya do. Motivate my mind, my mentally won't grow. Will you marry me? Will you marry me, baby? Make it official, you are me lady. Not a plan, you alone are my favorite. Always get in my mind, you're my baby. Just know yourself. Bad mind can't do me nothing for believing them. Look what you mean to me. Hey, look what you mean to me. It really nice enough to live our lives in love, huh? And I need you clean, you said you would be my queen. You saved me life enough, super.